All right, dudes. It's Steve here from Grasshorse. Welcome to Cartoon Chores, and we are going to continue to animate Bagel Candy. I had to kind of cut the last video short. So anyway, we're going through the process of adding this little doodad here to measure this distance to try and make it somewhat. And I know there's squash and stretch is happening here and everything on this character, but I just want to try and get an idea for how things are fitting. So that looks cool. That's cool. That one's a little low. This one's a little low, too. Roop. Hot diggity dog. Okay, so cut that there. Paste it here. All right. Go to the old cutter tool. Cut that. Put the pivot there. Rotate it up. Groovy. On to Z next. All right, this is the... Great. So we're now on the other side. Select the red line, and we want basically this length. Okay, and let's make it 5. That's cool. Copy next. Copy next frame. Paste. Where are you? Little rascal. Copy, next frame, paste, there you are. Move that there, ba-doop-ba-doop-ba-doo. Paste. Now this is gonna be the spot where it's most squished. And so, a minimum, it should be there. It looks kind of okay. Boop. Boop. Pivot moved on me. See, this one's way off. Shoop. There you are. Where are you? Yeah, I suppose I can just copy and paste it so I can copy it again so it's closer. I think we have like one more to do. Yeah, all right. one. Okay, yeah, there's one more to do. Great. All right, so let's go back, take a peek. This one for sure is going to be right. Oh, this one is not. Oof. Yeah. Forgot to move the pivot. Pretty good. Whew, this one's funky. This one I'm going to redraw. Now, why is this one so different? Stretch. That's why it's so different. All right, so if it's that much different, I'm going to make sure I go back to the line color. And we're going to do up and down and holy cow and over. Okay, do that. This is going to be an 8 is what it's going to be eventually. I've got to go through all these and get the... line work the right size. Select this. I'm going to move the pivot to its rotational point. So I rotate it up there. Weird. I did not expect that. But maybe that's why you do it that way. That one looks okay. This one here, can these rotate down? Let's move this one a little bit. I think that this one needs to move out a little bit like that and then move this. Okay. Roop. Cool. That looks good. That one needs tweaked. Pivot here. Cool. All right, so now let's go and remove these little doodads. Oh, come on. Cool. Now let's go back and make sure the line weighting's right. Because we know it's not, right? I don't know if I like that. I think it might be better at 6. I like it better at 6. Is this at 6? I do. That's at 8. I'm going to go through all of them and tweak them a little bit here. That's 6. Okay, that's cool. Ooh, I can just burn through all of them here. They're on their own layer. Nothing else on this layer but that. So cool. Let's do this. But wait. That did not work. Mr. Fancy Pants Hot Dog. I'm going to burn through all this. Look at me go. All right. So 6. Oops. That's not 6. All right, so these are 8 now, I believe. Look back here. This is 8, right? No, 6.4. 8. That's 8. This is not 8. That's 8. All right, so we're just going to work on these things. These are 6, right? So let's work on that aspect of those. It's already 8. 8. 6. 8. 6. 8. And this is actually an ugly line. Cool. All right. Groovy. Another first frame.
I think it's time for candy.
Tink, tink. What's going on? Why is it not selecting anything? This is that, right? Yeah, okay, I'm there. I'm on the right layer, selecting. There it goes, okay. Cool. Yeah, and let's do this. Do that down there too. Boop. Copy that. Radio paste. That rotate. All right, so copy next frame. That, delete, paste. Place that there, cool. This looks like it can scale a bit. Why did it not scale from that spot? I guess it doesn't scale from the rotational pivot. I didn't know that. It's a drag. There's that. Was it a little smaller? Whoa. I guess when you hold the Alt button, scale goes crazy. All right. So there we go. Let's see where we're at. See what it looks like now. Cool. All right, let's go back to the seam. We didn't get the seams taken care of yet. All right. We're on lines, good. Not quite to there, not quite to there, right in the middle. like. Another thick. Cool. They look good, though. They track nicely. And I suppose if we went to 8 frames, it's probably more likely what you're going to get off of a flipbook. Cool. 12 looks best. All right. So let's go back in there and tweak these pencil lines. Oops. Do 6. Okay, that's what that looks like. Great. All right. What do you say we try and color it? Give it a shot. See how it goes. Right, so the bag body. We'll do the bag body first. Boop, 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 boop. Down here. Dink, dink. There we go. I know we have to do a fill fix for the candy. So I'm not going to touch it up there yet. Well, really, I can just go in here and doop, do that, go here, candy, thoop, thoop. So, why be lazy? Hoofta. All right, so here, soup, do that. Here, bag of candy. Put that nothing there. Oops. Little rascal. Oh my goodness. Cool. We know. Oops. These need to be like this first. Then it will go better. Hopefully. Okay. There's that. What are you? Okay. What do you do in this situation? extra rascal there, aren't you? Rear end. All right. Have I gotten all those up there to this point? I have. Ooh, I am not moving fast. Guess it's fast enough. I might just go through and do all the little bolts, just because they're always going to be the first one to fill. Oh, are you kidding me? That's the little tiny, tiny line. I'm here. Let me get rid of that. That's absurd. Okay. Clear. Go there. That. Bank. Bag of candy. Boom. bag of candy. Do that. Actually, do it and then select it. Where are you? Are you there? There you are. That was a wrong color. That isn't a crazy idea. And so just do something like maybe like 2 pixels wide. Then we can do our little clear lines. And then maybe it'll help us get rid of that one. And then now we can do the bag of candy. Cool. All right. Control shift page down goes to the back. This is the other way of solving the problem. Is actually make the color you want it and just send it to the back. And it'll still be a pain in the butt. Yeah, basically, if I went through and I got rid of some of the hairs, that would probably solve some of the problem. It's those hairs that are interfering, making those incorrect painted areas. Close. The color does make it so much easier to read. Now, that's a crutch, too, in making it so that you have to have color for it to read. You don't want that. You want to read on its own. Shading wise, because not everybody color is subjective, and not everybody recognizes color the same way. And so you need to try and make your things, and it's just, in design wise, it's just better to have the values in order so that it still reads. Now I kind of try and what I do is called a squint test, where I close one eye and I squint the other, and I look at it and I say, okay, can I still see the difference between certain values? Like, this is going to be fairly bright. This is mid-range. This is a little bit darker. What in the world? Wow. Insanity is afoot. Amazing how many of these. That is the one thing about when you go through and just one color every frame and go through and do it. You miss some sometimes. You're just going, you move so fast, you miss some parts. Cool. Groovy. All right, so it's time to replace. So this one here is run right before contact. So this, boom. So this one here, select all this, copy. We're gonna go here, select this. You know what? I might just paste it up here just for temporarily. Then move this over here and kind of line up roughly what I was thinking. Then go down here, select this, delete, then go up here again, select this, cut it here and here, and then paste it. And then we have to go back and get this thing, copy, and then we need to paste that up here. Paste. Weird. We knew it fit. Cool. Can flip back and forth and see here how it's stretching and see if it looks like a nice stretch. Looks pretty good. Okay, so this one here is this here. So we'll select this, copy that, go here, paste, move this over here, go down here, delete that, go to this one, cut, go down here, paste. Now we need the scar. Copy that, go to here, paste that. And I could have gone through and for sure, I could have gone through and thrown that on a peg on that one frame and then have everything not animate and then move it to here in the right place on this frame. I could have done that. Why I didn't, I don't know. Honestly. All right, so then this one. Cool. Wow. Copy that. Go here. Paste. Bloop. Here. Delete that. Copy. Paste. Cool. All right, so I am going to take this doodad. Copy that, go here, paste that, see the scar on this one. Funny, after I made this orange color and put it in there, I was looking at the at our Reese's peanut butter cups. Psh. It's like, that's the Reese's peanut butter cups orange.
I like it.
Cool, man. Well, all right. Well, that wraps the animation for that shot, and or that part of the shot. We still have a whole jack-o'-lantern to be chasing this bag of candy, and maybe even a little piece of candy that flies out at some point, too. I'm seeing one issue. I thought I was done. I promise, but there's something weird. I'm not going to let it get by without it. See, look at that. One of those things, it's so strange that you can sit and look at it, like, you know, 10 times, and then the 11th time you go, wait a second, there's a problem. And you can do your best to be as organized as possible with it. Cool, man. All right. Anyway, we really are now done. So cool. Well, thank you again for checking this out. I hope you found it cool. I think it was like, what, it was under 4 hours to animate that shot, or at least that part of the shot. So that's cool. I don't try and make these videos long, trust me. I want them to be enjoyable to sit through and the like. And I hope you learned something. So anyways, if you like the content, share, like, and subscribe. Hit that notification button or bell if you want to find out when we go live. I try and go live at 7 a.m. on weekdays. Doesn't happen every weekday, but I do my very best to. So anyway, hope you're making cool stuff out there too. I'd love to see it. Feel free to share it with me on Instagram or whatever. So cool. Till next time, toodaloo.